You're listening to the Coupling Up Podcast. Ending a relationship can be profoundly difficult. Some people go their whole lives without ever truly moving on. So wouldn't it be great to have a professional who can guide you all the way through it? Someone who could give singles struggling with breakups, dating games, or loneliness the best tips for finding healthier romance? Well, you found her. This is the Coupling Up Podcast, and this is your host and teacher, Shawn Davis.
Hey, hey, it's Shawn with the Coupling Up Podcast, and today's episode, I'm going to share with you a Reddit poster who got submarined. So let's get into what submarining has to do with dating today. When you're in a great dating situation, you're vibing with the person you're talking to, you're going to come across ghosting. And that's bad enough. But when they come back suddenly, like a hero returning from war, blessing you with their text messages and calls, you probably just got submarined. Coming now in today's Reddit story, we're going to dive right in. Okay, so today's Reddit story goes like this. Once upon a time, the beginning of this year, I met a handsome young man. Things were going so well I dared to get my hopes up. Suddenly, the handsome man was too busy to see me and went MIA. Now he's back, and while I admit I was thrilled to hear from him, I'm also very hesitant that it's going to turn out, in the words of Rachel Bloom, me living off love kernels. Of course, there's a word for it, submarining. Well, it starts off with someone who you're involved with disappearing. A bit like ghosting, it goes from everything's fine and we're almost at the goodnight next stage to radio silence. Total nothingness. A bit like you've got a submarine gone under the water and you're literally incapable of contacting you. So far, it's just ghosting, but with more watery imagery. But then months later, they come back, much like an olden days sailor who shipped off, went under the sea, and then came back triumphant from his mission. He returns. And that's today's Reddit story, so let's get into the tip for handling this. So my tip today for this submarine story is you want to think about this much like any other ditch and run type concept that we're going to talk about on the show. When I introduce a new word like submarining, I want you to keep in mind that it's similar and it might even be the same as many of the other types of dating terms. It's all about human behavior, not about technology. So just like in last week's story, we talked about the slow fade, and in previous weeks, we went over ghosting, is that it relates to a person deciding that they're going to leave for whatever reason, and they're just not giving you the closure, the why as to, you know, why this is the situation you're in. So examples that we might be dealing with here is somebody who's afraid of intimacy and not wanting to move forward to more closeness because it creates anxiety or fear. There may be fear of expectations being placed on them. So what is this person going to want from me? And can I provide that, or do I want to provide that? Or even wanting the idea of romance and not the full thing. There may be many reasons for that. But if they come back, here's the thing I would wonder. Are they trying to control the speed of their feelings, or, you know, the expectations of what I might be feeling for them? Or even, you know, could they have a personal problem that they're going through, like chronic illness? And so any of those things can cause a person to leave like suddenly like that and possibly come back. The common thread, though, that I'm noticing in many, many of these dating stories is just like this one, is there's this expectation that intimacy is coming, that the next step is commitment. And then that's when the running happens. But the thing that is a little bit different in the submarine concepts is we see this heroic return. So this, like, just suddenly they just start texting or start calling or asking you out or acting like nothing really changed. So they could even try to act like you're crazy for asking where they went, like as if that's being controlling or something. So if they try to gaslight you, gaslighting means that they're trying to manipulate what you remember. If they try to do that and try to make it so that you're not concerned, worried, scared, or whatever you're feeling, I want you to work on trusting your gut and know that healthy communication is really just about showing up for another person and just ditching and then suddenly coming back. It's not giving you that consent that you might be looking for, right? So you want a partner who's going to communicate, hey, I need space, or hey, I have plans and just, you know, I'm not going to be available for whatever reason, is you want that communicated. So if we were to fast forward and let's say this turned into a marriage or heavy commitment with this person, is they might get stressed and run whenever the kids get sick or there's a sudden health crisis for somebody. Or if they're, you know, hiding the real life story, you know, they might be sick or homeless or something else. But you want the person you're dating to confide these things into you, not to hide and act like the concerns aren't there. You want that kind of care to be taken in a relationship. And you don't really want a person that's just trying to be perfect all the time and having no problems and hiding those sorts of things. So if you get the submarine, I want you to treat it like ghosting and expect an explanation that's honest when they return. You deserve a real person and you deserve that explanation and truthfulness of, you know, kind of what happened. And when they can't talk to you about the honest needs and feelings, like, you know, if they avoid texts or calls, it's time to move on and take the answer that they're showing you by their behavior. They're showing you they can't be trustworthy. They're showing you that communication is going to be lacking. And those are the things that you want to consider when you're accepting dates from people, though, is are they acting in a trustworthy way? Or, you know, could they not be allowing my feelings to be there and not allowing that communication? So submarining isn't typically something that we want to continue. If you do have somebody who is doing this, stand up for yourself, say, hey, this is my boundary. You're not going to be able to continue this behavior and date me. I would really love to have you in my life, and this is what I need from you instead. So just be willing to be a little bit more direct than maybe your gut feelings, you know, want you to be, and be willing to walk away if somebody is showing up in a way that makes you feel really negative. It's okay to gracefully walk away from these situations, but make sure that it's a situation you really do want to walk away from. All right, that's the tip for the day, and I'll see you guys next week.
Thank you for listening to the Coupling Up podcast. Shawn is a professional, licensed clinical social worker, and it's her mission to help you find healthier romance. We hope you've gotten some useful and practical information from this show. And we'll be back soon. But in the meantime, go to the website, renewthelove.com. While there, learn how to send messages in a dating app that shine. A free quickie course. Also, find the readiness to date checklist. Identify if you're ready to date or need to focus on healing first. See you next time on the Coupling Up podcast.